Hey guys, Anne with CNSave.com, back for the start of another vlog, and it's not been a good day thus far. First of all, I am breaking out like a horny teenager, and I don't know what's going on, and it's been going on all week, and it's just very upsetting. I don't know what to do, so I've tried to cover it up as much as possible, but my skin looks terrible, and if you're a woman, you know, well, probably a guy too. When your skin looks terrible, you just feel like crap. So there's that. But anyway, I woke up this morning to a neutral feedback on a jacket I'd sold, a vintage jacket, and the buyer said it was navy when it was black. And I'm like, oh, no, you know, all upset because I was sure it was black, but isn't color supposed to be kind of objective and people can't ding you for color? Because the scavenger life, that Ryan chick, she calls like every day eBay. And one of the things she always talks about is calling about someone saying it's the wrong color. So I call eBay and all he's doing is reading off the script. Well, that's someone's opinion and we can't change it and blah, 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 blah. I finally got so annoyed I hung up and I'm just like so ticked off. Well, then another vintage jacket just sold. I went down to get that one. Then I realized, oops, the guy who left the feedback was right. I sent him the navy jacket. The black jacket is still here. So I got a neutral feedback. My fault, I sent the wrong item, but he never contacted me. Had he, I would have looked it up and probably realized it was the wrong one. The neutral doesn't affect feedback, so whatever. Or your rating score, your overall score, it doesn't affect that, so fine. So then this other guy who bought the jacket that the other guy now has, I had to put in a cancel order, refund that. So yeah, things happen, but so I try, when I get those vintage jackets, I try to separate the black from the blue because they can look just alike. And these were very similar. They were different brands, but the collars were the same. And that's where I got tripped up. When the first one sold, I went down and I saw the collar. And I was like, oh, it's this one. So I didn't look close enough. Need to do that. Lesson learned. Yeah, so that's been my eBay morning. I did have a sale. This is one of those cable and gauge, I don't know, pieces I got at TJ Maxx. And this is the first item from my TJ Maxx haul that has sold. So it sold for $39.99. I can't remember, I paid 10 or less for this. It was a 3X, so I think that's why it sold so fast. And I did put free shipping on it because it's light enough to go via first class. I've packaged it in one of those suffocation bags that I have for FBA stuff. So it'll just slip into an envelope and be able to ship out that way. Yeah, so I am just finishing up my blog work for the day. And then there's a truck outside my window. There's a goal. My goal is to get some photographs listed. No, photographs taken so I can list on eBay. Start going through the estate sale stuff that I've gotten the last couple weeks. I want to get that churned out. So that's the plan, but best laid plans, they always fall apart around here. So anyway, I'm gonna get this ready because the mail hasn't come yet and we are in care pickup, so I can get that out. Oh, that brings me to the point about the new eBay seller update changes. I don't know. Anyway, the spring ones have just come out. First of all, I never read them. I just wait for somebody else to go through them and tell me what they are. So basically they're taking the final value fee down from 20 to 10%. And was there anything else? You're going to get like some credit for some sponsored ads. Yeah. So anyway, right now I'm a top rated seller plus and a power seller, which I've always been a power seller, but I'm top rated seller plus. And that is because I offer next day shipping and 30 day returns as well as feedback score. So I've always offered next day shipping since the day I started selling on eBay back in 2005. So that's not going to change. And as far as 30 day returns, I used to have 7, then went to 14, now it's 30. I have not seen any difference, problems with that. I always just strive to create a good listing in the first place, making sure that there's good photos, good title, accurate description, measurements. And I think that's, you know, like I always say, the best advice I ever got was to under promise and over deliver. So if you say you're gonna ship in 3 days, ship the next day. If an item is in like new condition, say it's in very good condition. Take things down a notch so your buyer's always happier. than they thought they were going to be when they get the item. And I see so many people, and it's always the men. It's always the guys. Mint. This is in mint condition. It's mint. That's one of my serious pet peeves. And it's always the guys. It's always the guys with their mint condition. It's in mint condition. And it's not. First of all, mint condition, is it just rolled off the factory assembly line and no one's touched it? That's mint condition. Especially when you start getting into collectibles and whatnot. I would never describe anything on eBay as in mint condition. I have a typewriter that doesn't look like it's ever been used. It's vintage, whatnot. I put, doesn't appear to have ever been used. But as with all estate sale fine, or with all vintage items, we sell as is. I'm not like, mint, rare. Oh, that's another one, rare. Put it in the, I have a friend who does that. He puts everything in title, rare. Sometimes he'll have rare in the beginning and then rare at the end. That is a waste of keyword space. Rare, mint. Under promise, over deliver. That just drives me bonkers. So anyway, I try to do that so I don't have problems with returns. So yeah, that's my thought on that. I guess I'll keep doing that, get the 10%. It'll be interesting when these credits come out, how they work. I'm not really worried about it. eBay's always kind of changing things and playing with it, but for the most part, it doesn't really end up affecting my business that much. Just keep chugging along. So anyway, I'm gonna go get this shipped out and I will check in with you guys if anything exciting happens later on. I don't know if it will, maybe, maybe not. Probably not, but I'll still check in. So I'm in my office and I am listing, and I have just recently discovered these two, the bin pickers, and I love them. Husband and wife, they're a little older, and by older I don't mean old, but I mean, you know, a little more my age people. and I just love them. They go to the bins, the Goodwill bins, and they go do some retail and they share their finds, and they're just, I love them. They're down to earth. And I just really enjoy watching these. And I've been trying to follow more channels lately. Although I think, I don't know if you guys have had this, but there was a big thing. YouTube unsubscribed a bunch of people, channels. And I've definitely found that, because I went back. I was like, well, wait a minute. Aren't I subscribed to this person, that person? No, I've been unsubscribed. So I'm trying to resubscribe. And I'm trying to do follow for follow on Instagram for public accounts. I know a lot of people have their accounts private. And so I'm not following those people back, because I guess if they, I don't know, if they set it private, I'm thinking they just want their family and friends to follow. That's what I kind of think. So anyway, I don't know. I'm trying to get better at following back. But same with Instagram. I've done follow back, and then I'll go on and it's like, it's unchecked again. And so I don't know. Anyway, I'm trying. So if you guys have a YouTube channel about reselling or couponing or Dollar Tree hauls or holler hauls, or, you know, whatever, make sure to let me know in the comments so I can try and go and follow you back. Like I said, YouTube did a big unsubscribing thing for some reason. I think it was a glitch last month, so I may have been subscribed to you and got unsubscribed. So anyway, leave your comments below. Just let me know that you have a channel and I can click on your bio and head over there to subscribe back to you. And here is my current situation listing. I've gotten these items listed. I'm doing these mugs, those pottery bowls. Need to do photos of that stuff. I'm trying to go through my, you know, estate sale finds to get this stuff caught up. This is a label maker I bought for myself. I never used it. I just don't know. Printing it out on paper and taping it has worked for 12 years. And that's just whatever. This is what we're going to do. Then I have that pile there to go through of estate sales stuff. And then some stuff in the living room. Stuff is really piling up, but you know, this is the time of year when stuff is so dang cheap. How can you not buy it? So anyway, trying to plug through and list, get photos done while I have some daylight, but it's fading fast. We're gonna get snow tonight, tomorrow, and then on the weekend it's gonna be in the 60s. So makes no sense, but oh well, keep plugging away. And I've moved my mannequin thing there. I can't show you because it's right out the window, but anyway, there, my table back in the corner. So I'm always switching these two things, table, mannequin. It's kind of a pain in the butt, but oh well, first world problems. Just had an eBay sale. This is funny. I got this Elf on the Shelf pattern in February 2016, Barnes & Noble $2 sale. I initially sent it to Amazon, didn't sell. I got it back, put it on eBay, didn't sell. I was like, oh, forget it. I'm just going to donate it or take it to the consignment store, sell it there, whatever. But then I was like, well, maybe I should try to just load my store up with as much stuff as possible. So I was like, oh, I'll just put it back on eBay and it can sit. And I listed it for $9.99. And within minutes of me listing it, it sold. So I paid two, sold for $9.99. Buyer paid shipping on top of that. It's going to be easy to ship, obviously. Then I'm going through comments and questions, which I do try to answer. So if I can't answer, I at least try to give it a thumbs up. It depends on if I'm on my phone or my laptop. Question about getting ungated in clothing and how was the process. All I had to do was go in and request approval, and I got it instantly. It said based on my selling performance. However, there's still a lot of brands that are locked. So at the end of the day, I'm like, oh, forget it. I'm just going to sell on eBay. Dorky Thrifters, if you are not following them, please go over to their channel and subscribe. This is a couple who, full-time eBay sellers. They originally had a home and property and everything. I think they were renting, and they had to get out of their rental quick, so they were living in an RV between buying homes. They homeschool, they're still selling on eBay. The husband recently passed away unexpectedly, died of a heart attack. So now the wife is raising their daughters in the RV and still selling on eBay. And she specializes in eyeglasses and sunglasses. So a lot of great information. So please go over Dorky Thrifters and subscribe to them and show them some support. We love Papa, yes. Jewelry box or jewelry openings. People definitely want to see that. My Kmart looks like that all the time. Yep, my Kmart, oops, drop that. My Kmart looked junky even before they started the clearance sale. Do I have photos or do I have vlogs on how to store photos on iCloud? I don't. I have an iPhone 6S Plus, and I have the middle one, the one that they price them based on the storage capacity. And I have the one that's in the middle, so it has a lot of room. Let's see, more jewelry requests. Does Ann scan? Yes, I use the Amazon seller app. It's free. How do I know if clothing is vintage? Different things, the way the label looks, the brand, if it was produced in the United States and now it's produced in China. If the label says US, that probably means vintage. Basically, if the label says made in China, number one clue, it's not vintage. If anything is marked made in China, number one clue, it's not vintage. How will I sell the Walgreens clearance stuff? On eBay, I will. And some I'm just going to take to the consignment store. Poplar. I always want to say popular or polar, but it's Poplar. Congratulations on 15,000 subscribers. Thank you. If you like Breaking Bad, Better Call Saul is a good show. Yeah, I have that in my watch list. More jewelry requests. Good idea on the plate rack. And you can get them cheaper. That plate rack that I got at Sam's Club that I was going to get for my kitchen, but I just put it downstairs for my inventory. Yeah, you can get those cheaper, but since I already had it, I took it downstairs. Yeah, Harley Pig sold on Merchant Fulfilled a few weeks back. Problem with the one I had, the person cut the tag off a butt. So I just donated it. More agreement on the Amazon sweet boxes being pretty crappy. I agree. And then lots and lots of support for me commenting about the comments about me yelling at Papa. Okay, so I always, like I said, try to comment back to you guys when you leave questions or comments. If nothing else, I try to give it a thumbs up. Sometimes it just depends if I'm on my phone or laptop. And some people's accounts are set, and they may not know it, that you can't reply. So, but I do read them. And if you are a YouTuber, here's a trick. You go into your account and you click here on the side. And if you click under community and under comments, that brings up all the comments in the order they've been left. And then you can just reply that way. It makes it a lot easier than opening up each video and trying to do it that way. So I try to do it this way, and that way I can catch them all. So again, just go to your Creator Studio and under community, click comments to see everything. It is now Wednesday night, and I just sold this Arrow sweatshirt. This is one of those that I got at Gordman's during their 50% off additional clearance, and I either paid $5 or $7.50 for this. I think I paid $5 for these, and it sold for $39.99, and I did put free shipping on these clothes. It's over a pound, so it's going to go in a flat rate bubble mailer. So yay, now I've sold one piece from
the TJ Maxx sale and one piece from the Gordman sale. And you know, my thoughts on these is I picked the prices that I wanted to get and I'm just gonna wait on them. So might be trickling out a little slower. You know, it might take a while. Of course, most of them are winter, but I'm just gonna stay firm on my prices and wait it out. So it makes me feel better, like to at least have had, you know, one from each of the sales sell. Gives me hope that eventually they all go. Cause you know, when you come home from a big haul like that, it's like, oh gosh, should I do the right thing? Is this stuff gonna sell? Yeah, so I'm very happy for this first Gordman's piece to sell. Just had another eBay sale come through as I was getting ready to go to bed. This is a Casey Coleman denim shirt. Now, I didn't know the brand, but it was a 2X. It was denim, and it's a teacher-themed shirt. So I knew that there would be an educator out there who would love to have this. So I got it at Goodwill for a dollar. I think I got this at the dollar sale. Yeah. It sold for $24.99. I did have free shipping on it. I'm just trying to be more competitive with my clothing, and I'm going to somehow get it in a flat plate and bubble mailer if it's the last thing I do. It's long, so I shall get it in there though. It is Thursday morning and I had one sale overnight. It was a good one. This set of flatware I paid $9 for and it sold for $99.99 and the buyer paid shipping on top of that. This is a Marcrest and another one of these Atomic Starburst patterns, which I told you guys about. You will probably find a lot of once you start looking for flatware, but it's important that you find the exact manufacturer because a lot of people did it. So this one, people want to know what how you figured out. Well, it is stamped on the back, Marcrest. So I had that to go on and that it's stainless. So then I was able to do a search and look through the patterns online. I have the sites the sites I use to research flatware are linked below. So it's a curved Citation, it's got a curve to it, and it's the Atomic Starburst stainless. So anyway, yay, hard work with the flatware pays off. I know there are times I don't want to do it, don't want to research it, count it, lay it out, all that stuff, but it does pay off if you get the right pattern, good pictures, it's clean. My dad cleans it with silver polish. Again, that's linked below, the one we use, and then he washes it to clean it up and looks good. So good sale to start the day. It is now almost dinner time. I've been busy listing, sorting, rearranging all kinds of stuff today. Nothing interesting to film, but I've been very busy. But I just sold two of these frozen journals. I got these at the Barnes & Noble $2 clearance sale, so I paid $2 for each. I sold them for $9.95 each. One person bought two, so they paid $9.95 each. And they paid shipping on top of that, so I will go ahead and get that out. And with that, I'm going to wrap up this vlog so I can get it uploaded to go up tomorrow. So if you guys are liking these vlogs, please be sure to give this one a thumbs up, leave a comment or question below, and hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. And hitting the little bell next to the subscribe button apparently tells you when a new video goes up. I haven't done it, but that's the word on the street. So anyway, thanks so much for watching. Bye.